Hi, I'm Simon Mitchell, and today we're going to show you how we do the signwriting on the side of our train. The typeface is the original New South Wales Government Railways typeface. We've recreated that on Inkscape and split it out into the four different colours. We then use our vinyl cutter to cut each of the colours. This is just positioning the cutting head to commence cutting. The bottom layer in the lettering is black. It's the shadow effect, and this sets out the spacing between the lettering for when we apply it to the carriage side. The first thing we do is remove any of the black from around the outside of the lettering, and then I'll use the solid black as a guide for cutting. My ruler's got a little lip on the back of it which drops into the slot where the vinyl cutter has cut the vinyl, which is very handy. I then remove the solid black in between the letters, and the square around the letters provides a guide for the next layer when I'm applying that. I like to do yellow as the first colour, and again I'm using the little lip on the back of the ruler to just drop into the slot where the vinyl cutter has cut between the letters. Sometimes it's a little bit hard to find. The next process is called weeding, where we remove the excess vinyl from around the letter. I then do the same process with red, cutting again to the same size. So each of these squares is the same size as the black, and that's the way that I line things up when I'm doing the different layers. Then we do the weeding for the red parts. These are a lot smaller than yellow, and we've got to be very careful that we don't accidentally take away some of the red shading and go and have to recut it, which has happened quite a few times. The most fiddly colour is white. These are just little highlights on the red, and they're so fine. You've got to be so careful that you don't take them away when you're removing the excess. I don't try to place these using the alignment method. It's much, much better to just use some of the transfer tape that you'll see in a moment and place them on the individual letters where they need to be. So this is being compressed as much as I can so that we minimise the wasted white. And now we come to the assembly stage. You can see that we've still got the white backing for the black. This provides the spacing between the letters so that we've got half a chance when we're on some scaffolding on the side of the carriage. I haven't weeded all of the black from around the letters. That solid black then provides the alignment when we do the additional layers of the yellow and the red on top of the black. For the next stage, we use transfer paper, which is tacky and doesn't provide a permanent bond with the vinyl. We line up the corners of the white backing for the S, roll the transfer tape over the top, then we peel the backing, it's sort of a waxed finish, off the back of the letter, and then hinge down over the top of the black, rubbing down from the top to the bottom so we don't get air bubbles, and as you can see, we can then peel the transfer tape back. Then we follow the same process with the red, again aligning the white backing with the corners of the black, peeling back carefully because it's a lot of finer detail there. And then the transfer paper will line this up over the yellow very nicely. Again, we're working from the top down to the bottom to make sure we don't have any air bubbles. And a bit of a bonus there, we've pulled away the rest of the black. Luckily, timing is perfect because we've just finished doing the red and the yellow. And we move on to the next letter. Finally, we do the white little highlights. I find this is a lot easier if I've got an offcut of the transfer paper and I can pick up each little white highlight individually and position that in exactly the right spot. Trying to line up all of these little tiny bits using the alignment method would be just too difficult, and I seem to be able to get away with it doing it this way. So we keep going with that process until we've got all of the letters done, and here we've got enough for almost two carriages. And here we see the lettering in place on the carriage. This is a twinette carriage 2335, which is normally carriage E in our consist. She's seen here right at the end of her restoration, being pushed back into the radial roads at Goulburn Locomotive Roundhouse by our good friend Lance on board Smokey Joe, the yard shunter. Thanks for watching. We hope you've enjoyed seeing some of the detail that we apply when we restore our ex-Southern Aurora sleeping carriages.